Hey there, it's Kaylee. Are you ready to take our knowledge of one-step inequalities one step further? Now we're going to be working with negative numbers doing multiplication and division. Let's go. Okay, so we're still solving one-step inequalities, but this time we have a negative number in our inequality. So if we want to find the solutions for our variable x and then graph the solution, what do we have to do? Yeah, we just need to get this x all by itself. And how can we do that? Yeah, we just have to divide by this negative 5. So if I divide this side by negative 5, what do I do to the other side? I also divide by negative 5. But here is a crucial step. When we need to multiply or divide by a negative number when we're working with inequalities, we actually flip this inequality sign. Say what? I know, it sounds crazy, but let me show you with a simple example. So let's say we have 3 is less than 4. That's true, right? Of course, 3 is less than 4. But what if now I have to divide both sides by negative 1? So if I divide this side by negative 1 and this side by negative 1, remember, as long as I do it to both sides, it's okay. But what am I left with? Well, this will turn to negative 3 is less than negative 4. Wait, is this true? Is negative 3 less than negative 4? That's not true. Negative 3 is actually greater than negative 4. So when we multiply or divide by those negative numbers, what I actually do is I'd have negative 3, negative 4, and then I need to flip this sign around. So I'm actually going to say negative 3 is greater than negative 4. And that is true, right? Yeah, we know that that's true. So whenever we multiply or divide by negative numbers, we have to flip our inequality sign to keep the inequality true. So same thing now that we're back with our original inequality. If I've divided by my negative number over here, I'm left with just x. And over here, 15 divided by negative 5, that'll give me negative 3. But when I bring this inequality sign down, I'm actually going to flip it. So instead of saying greater than or equal to, I'm going to say less than or equal to. Following that same logic, right? To keep the inequality true, we have to flip the sign. Perfect. So here our solution is x is less than or equal to negative 3. We can graph that solution if we get out our number line. We'll put our 0 right here. We got negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, and over here we have 1, 2, 3. Okay, where do I start my solution set? At negative 3, right? Open or close circle? Close, because negative 3 is included. And what direction does my arrow go? Well, x is less than or equal to. Remember, I flipped my sign. So my arrow is going to point to all the numbers that are less than negative 3. Amazing. So let's just double check. Since this is kind of funky and our first time doing it, let's double check and plug in a solution. So let's say we plug in when x is equal to negative 4. So we plug it in here. We'll have negative 5 times negative 4 is greater than or equal to 15. So remember, I'm using my original inequality. So I use my greater than or equal to. I'm going to have negative 5 times negative 4. That gives me positive 20 greater than or equal to 15. Is that true? It sure is. Look at that. We did it right. Okay, let's try this one. Our inequality says y over negative 12 is less than 2, and we have to solve for the variable and graph the solution. So what do I do first? I need to get this y by itself, so I have to undo this division with negative 12. I can undo division with multiplication. So I'm going to multiply this side by negative 12, and I do the same thing over here, multiply by negative 12. But ding, 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 what's the rule? If we multiply or divide by a negative number with an inequality, what are we going to do? We're going to flip this sign. So we can start, just flip our sign right there. So my negative 12s cancel out. I'm left with y is now greater than 2 times negative 12 is negative 24. Amazing. So let's plot our solution now. Let's say we have 0 here. How about we count by 4s, huh? We'll have 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24. Oop, and I forgot my negative signs here. These are all our negative numbers. And over here we have 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24. Okay, where am I going to start my solution set? At negative 24, right? Way over here at the end. Open circle or closed circle? Do I fill it in? Nope. Why? Because it's not actually included. And then it's saying y is greater than all of those numbers. So here we go. We're including all of the numbers greater than negative 24 in our solution set. Awesome. So why don't we plug in a number here to see if we did it right? How about in between here, we'd have a negative 6. Let's say negative 6 is our number. So if we're going to say y is equal to negative 6, what will our inequality say? We'd have negative 6 over negative 12 is less than 2. Negative 6 divided by negative 12, well, my negatives turn to positives, and then I can simplify this fraction to 1 half is less than 2. Is that true? Is a half less than 2? It sure is. Nice work. We did it right. Now, just to be clear, when we're working with one-step inequalities with addition and subtraction that have negative numbers, we do not flip the inequality sign. We only flip the inequality sign when we multiply or divide by a negative number. All right, you've crushed it. You can now solve one-step inequalities with multiplication and division when you have negative numbers. Go ahead and practice on your own. Have fun, and remember to always be clever. Hey.